we are gonna try to work on the horse now because we worked on the guy last time. His pants, his outfit looks more or less okay, but the horse still looks like a very sketchy and angular. So we need to make him, you know, polish him so he feels happy to be here in the live with us and he's not ashamed. Right, so we're gonna focus a lot about color, as you know, and temperatures, because the values are already set. What I mean by this is that, as you see in this part right here, let me take green so you can see well. Here, the value, the statement about the value is already done. More or less, if you squint, the value will be this, okay? So if you put the thing in black and white, okay. This is the value statement. So now that we know this, we're gonna stay in this value range, and inside we can play with colors, and playing with colors mean playing with temperatures, because if you play with color without paying attention to temperatures, your work is gonna look really, 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 really off. You want an example? Okay, I give you an example. These pants are red and they are lit by a warm sun, so it's a warm red. And if you play with colors without taking care of temperatures and you go with a cool red like this, then it's not gonna look anymore lit by a warm sun. See, but once you have the value, you need to focus on temperatures. When you will have it in mind, your work will step up suddenly. But that's why I'm, you know, pressing a lot on this button, like temperature watch out, temperature watch out. So here you see too cold, right? Look at the color wheel. I want to go somewhere around here, and actually, because I'm on the gray part, it's gonna act like it's bluish, yet it's gonna stay warm. That's the trick. That's one of the secret tricks of painting. It looks colder than the light area, still it's not pure like this, which would look very, very off. Or not, if you're painting like expressionist, which is okay, but if you want to paint like fine arts, then that's super important. And to be honest, this temperature concept is one of the most difficult to get. Like, it took me quite a lot of time. Really pay attention to the color wheel. And the color wheel basically is my palette, the virtual palette, but it's the same concept. So if you understand what I'm trying to search when I'm there, then you understand probably the concept of stamps and values and saturation also. I'm staying a lot on the gray side, and this is something super important. Usually when people paint, they tend to be really high in saturation, whilst nature in general is way grayer than we think. That's something else that you can also use to make your painting, to help your painting look more realistic, is staying on the gray part of the color wheel and basically use color where you need it or to attract the attention. So this would be for composition, or yeah, just for aesthetical qualities. Like, you want things that are muted, and next to this, something that really pops in terms of chroma. And this is also giving a nice contrast. But if you put everything high in chroma, it's not gonna look good. Each time you have a change of plan, you also have a higher a part which is higher in saturation, which is at the border. Like here, for instance, at the border of the shadow, it's a warm sun, so it's also gonna have a warmer edge. But it should be progressive and soft. You don't want something super sharp, you see? It's just like this, bringing some warmth at the edge. And this really gives a cool light effect. It's free, it's given with a lot of love. Take it, use it, and be happy. The same here, you see I've put this saturated part at the edge, but we're gonna make it even more. And here I'm thinking about, should I put all the details of this fold, you know, having little creases and such, or should I just compress the light value in one? Let's try. Here I'm putting little nuances, as you see, like there are some folds here and there. Sometimes it's good to compress the value, and I mean so much that, you know, it's just a big flat light area. But this would be more for if you're exposing for the shadows, because we expose for the light, we want some value shift in the light areas. So probably these little creases here and there are welcome, because they are sustaining the exposure for the light. But you don't want to go too high in value. That's something super important. You want to stay compressed in a logical way. What does this mean is that you don't want to go too dark, something like this, because this would be out of the compression. If you have a super, super strong and closed crease, like for instance, I would, on my shirt, it would be like this, right? Maybe this part here could be like super dark, okay? I mean darker, but because here it's basically flat, this whole plan is facing the light, you cannot have super high value shift. It's gonna stay more or less in the same, with just a little more or a little less, just to give, you know, some topology to the saddle. Okay, so let's go for the horse. I think we played a little enough here. Let's work his face a little bit. So gray horse, complex to do. Why is this? Because anything that is gray or white, you know, I mean light, gonna catch so many variations, like cool worm from the sky, from the environment. There are gonna be many shifts. You wanna stay general, you see? For this part, I was here because I was starting to detail, but here the horse is just a sketch now. So I don't wanna go like this and try to put the details, because I would lose the, you know, the general view of the head. And it's through the general view of something that you can get proper relationships between values, colors, stamps, saturation, and so on. So we're gonna keep it here for the moment. Maybe we go a little more opaque so we can really understand well which tone we use. It's having some reflected light from underneath. Hey, horse, huh? Should have chosen something easier, like a duck, but the Moroccan guard on the duck, not so stylish, huh? So now I'm just putting color notes. As you see, I'm not trying to blend or anything. I'm just trying to establish a roadmap of temperature, contrast, value, all these kind of things. Too dark. It's crazy. Like all the years and centuries, all these fundamentals, you know, these rules, which has been established step by step, little by little by humans. It's insane. So color accent still, but you see when we zoom out, the horse now starts to look more or less like a horse, and he's not anymore just a vague triangle like at the beginning. Like, yes, I paint horses, yee-hee! And then your collector is like, next. So here he's catching the light from the sky, so he's quite bluish, but not that bluish, like you went really too blue, like a smurf. Here is bluish too. Then warm, because it's warm, it's a warm sense. Inside you put some warmth and transparency. Let's make this more transparent. Hey, yes, that's the magic. And we can start to blend a little forms. Here, let's put some warm shadow around the eye, so the eye starts to be more in 3D, then a little warmer. Okay. See how I'm using warm color, but on its gray side, which makes it look cool. I want to make the muzzle pinkish just here around the lips, because he's having a little bit of pink. When I switch to pink, it's the color is so off. I cannot put this. It's going to look, you see, like pink plastic from a Barbie. So I'm going to go back here and I'm just going to try to go beige, and the beige compared to the rest will look pinkish. Haha, magic. The magic of painting. The same, look how blue this looks. This looks so blue compared to the warm background, but I'm just here. It's just the gray. Fan art is very close somehow to science, to math, to all these kind of things. I really like to use all these kind of variations, you see, because the brush is semi-transparent. It brings this different tone shifts. Additionally, you do this with picking a brush, you know, and a soft brush and just moving in the fresh paint. Here, it's a little bit of a mess on the ref. I'm just gonna improvise, huh? He has this thing where he puts his teeth. I'm here putting color notes here and there. And you see, you don't really need texture if you control well your color notes and they are logical and you have a good understanding of values and temps and so on. Your work looks consistent enough that you don't really need like crazy texture all around with, you know, these kind of things and splashes and back. I will probably put some afterward to give it, you know, some dynamics. But for building the whole thing, honestly, you can be really chill in terms of brushes. You don't need to go too crazy. Here I start to zoom, meaning that I'm gonna start putting more details. These little neat points, look, when you zoom out, give some texture to the horse. This one is just a little too much. Okay, here we have a cast shadow, and I love cast shadows because then you can work with a strong edge and it looks so good. Give me a second and we're gonna be doing it. Doing it. Okay, so look at the magic. Here, we're gonna bring a sharp light edge and it's gonna look awesome. We take this color, a neat brush like this, meaning without like edges that are blurred, and we just do like this. You have this sharp edge and look. I love this. I love cast shadows. When you put this sharp edge, it suddenly looks so good. These are my little daily pleasures as a painter. Warm contour, even better. Yo, a horse is starting to take shape, huh, compared to the beginning. Let's save this. Imagine my computer crashes again. Today's stream 5. Let's go. go. You sing when you paint? Sometimes I would really like to be back at school, painting in the atelier, you know, with everyone. What a cool sensation. Then when you turn professional, the lonely life starts, working in your studio nonstop, not seeing anyone. Your student years, probably as an artist, are the years where you're the most social. So if you're a student, if there are some students listening now, really enjoy this aspect, because afterward, it's really about being with yourself all the time in the studio. I'm a social animal. Like, my personality, you know, I'm human friendly, if this can be said. And this is something I don't like when I'm... One of the few aspects I don't like of painting is this loneliness. People who are in a music band, for instance, they will tell you, no, it's cool to be alone because you don't have the problems that, you know, having a team brings. But for me, I don't know. Seeing people around is really, it's really cool. So I try to see people outside of the studio. Like, after the scream, I'm going for a barbecue with some friends and, you know, it's cool. Or I play video games sometimes at night too with my team. So it's the same. I'm discussing with people. I go to the restaurant also. I like to go to the restaurant. All these kind of things, but just to make me feel, you know, that I'm basically living, that I'm not just a workshop rat. Working his ass off to be the best version of himself. I mean, the best painter version. Hey, looking better. We're doing this horse a little beauty. See, right now I'm using a brush. This brush. For the hair, it's quite cool. Okay, the horse is better. Let's do the leash. Because the leash now looks like a total mess. What is this? It's like eaten by an alligator. So let's fix this. Let's fix the alligator leash. Not trying to be super regular here, because on the leash, if you're gonna do it super uniform, it's gonna look artificial. And you want your leash to it'll be dynamic. Everything you do in painting anyway needs to look somehow dynamic, and this comes with a subtle shift between angles and curves. So you see, it's still a little angular, so it gives dynamics. The details I put, you see, are always going in the direction of compression, of grouping, of simplification, and then from far it looks detailed, but it's not really. But that's the trick. If you get a good understanding of color, saturation, temperature, values, you're gonna make your object or your horse or whatever you're painting look convincing, yet without adding too many details. And if you have not a really crisp understanding of these fundamentals, you're probably gonna put like a ton of detail, yet it's never gonna look convincing enough. So you're gonna keep adding detail, keep adding, and it's never gonna look okay. And they're gonna save you a lot of time, because then when you have a convincing result with just a few accents here and there, then you're good to go. You don't need to spend hours. I really love horse riders in the sun. Makes me think of really cool big compositions with lots of people and stuff. Here we're having another cast shadow. Once again, woo, can be very bold. Okay, we're gonna stop the painting for today. So my friends, we'll meet on Thursday, still talking, chatting about painting, about fine arts like we did. I will still explain you concepts that I find important to make your work step up and all these kind of things. And we'll meet, of course, on Instagram, through posts, stories, DMs. If you have any question, you can just DM me and I'll be happy to answer. I'll see you very soon, and you have a great and inspired day. Bye-bye.